strike in Timmins. Can you tell us now that you've had a chance to review the situation when you gave the directive to them to stop doing so?
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, for the question. Thank you to the member. Indeed, certainly, as you did know, I did contact the ONTC after you asked the question, and indeed, they did provide that service to the company as one of their regular customers. But they were apprised of the concerns that were there, and they committed that will not be happening again. So that was a one-time instance, Mr. Speaker. Won't be happening again.
That's great.
Well, we'll be monitoring the situation, but here's the interesting part. Now we have the Ontario Northland lending equipment to Xstrata in order to move trains on their property. So I'm going to ask you again, when is the McGuinty government going to tell the ONR to stay out of that picket line and to allow the parties to resolve their issues and not to cross the picket line by way of either staff or using Crown equipment to go onto that property?
Jeez. Minister?
Well, again, Mr. Speaker, thank you very much for the question. Indeed, that was a one-time occurrence, as I indicated, and as the ONTC acknowledged and recognized that it would not be happening again, and certainly there are other measures that have been put into place to try and deal with some of the implications of the loss of revenue to one of their main customers. But I can assure you that indeed the determination was made very, very clearly to me that indeed that was a one-time occurrence. It was certainly an opportunity for them to recognize that indeed there were some concerns expressed about this, and indeed an opportunity for me to express our concerns and our belief in the and support for the collective bargaining system, Mr. Speaker. And I can tell you that indeed that was a one-time occurrence, and it will not be happening again.
Thank you.